Bevy is somehow always getting better. No matter when I last looked at it, there's always a new feature, there's always some PR that just got merged, there's always some new activity that is super exciting. Today, we are exploring Bloom, which recently got added to Bevy's renderer. Now, I do have to say, if you see any glitches in this demo app, it is probably my fault because I am also running OBS at the same time, and there's quite a bit of calculation going on my laptop. So what is Bloom? Bloom is a specific effect that a light source has on a camera where if you look at any of these lights that are the bright lights, not the dark lights, you'll see these featherings on the sides. So you have this light, it has an effect on kind of the screen space around it that results in this kind of like emissive color coming off of it and feathering out. So we can change a couple of things in this demo. We can change the threshold. So if I turn that to a negative number, we get very white stuff. If I turn this up and up and up and up and up, eventually it just cuts off the kind of like emissive feathering. I'm probably never going to get that back to 1.0. So I'll just leave it as close as I can. Then we've got the knee that can go up and down, and the knee going up and the knee coming back down. Now this was set at 0.1, so I'm going to try to get it there. Then we've got scale. So we'll scale up here and we'll see that the feathering for each of the globes gets bigger and bigger and bigger. If we scale this down, it should get smaller and smaller and smaller. We're at 1 right now. And then I don't actually know what it's supposed to do if it goes negative. But if we keep it at 0, there we go. And then we've got intensity, which we can bring up, which makes the lights more intense, as you can see. And then we can bring the intensity back down and kind of get it to a similar effect. Now, if we go negative, we do get this kind of weird effect where I want to call it like, I can't remember what those orbs that morph together are called, but it looks kind of like that to me. Anyway, I don't think you're supposed to set intensity to a negative number, so I'm going to bring that back out. But that's the demo. So Bloom is this effect that comes off of these spheres onto the sort of camera. And I'm going to kind of keep this going on the side as we look at the code here. So the first thing to note is that Bloom is a shader effect. We talk about shaders quite a bit on this channel, so that shouldn't be too surprising. The demo app is bloom.rs in the Bevy repo, which I'll leave a link to in the description if you want to follow along. We've got the typical starting plugins for a Bevy app. We've got the default plugins. We've got a startup system to set up the scene. We can update the Bloom settings and we can bounce the spheres. So the spheres bouncing up and down isn't particularly interesting for talking about Bloom. And then updating the Bloom settings is taking those settings that we just explored, like the threshold and the scale and the intensity, and letting you change them. So all of the Bloom is basically set up in the setup function. So to get Bloom to show up, we need approximately three things. We need our 3D camera to have HDR enabled. We need the Bloom settings components to be inserted onto that camera as well. And we need the material that we're using for the spheres to have an emissive color. So we do all of that here. We set up the 3D camera. We give it a position and set HDR to true on the camera. We set up the Bloom settings to be the defaults. And the emissive texture is on a standard material, or rather the emissive color is a field on the standard material, and standard material is backed by a whole swath of WGSL files and things like that that we probably won't get into right now. So a standard material can have an emissive color or it can have a base color. A base color is what we see in these gray spheres, while the emissive color is the things that look like light sources. So we can create a mesh from an icosphere, which is what's going to give us these spheres. We can take positions in the world, so X and Z. If you consider Y to be up and down, then X and Z is the horizontal plane. So we can place a bunch of spheres at different points. In this case, they're from negative 10 to 10 in both directions. We basically randomize each of the spheres itself to determine which one should be a gray sphere and which one should be a light sphere. And then we can spawn one of the new PBR bundles with our mesh, our standard material with the emissive color, and the transform. We also add a bouncing component so that we control the y-axis, so the spheres go up and down. And that's pretty much it, which is pretty freaking cool. So if you're using a standard material and you want to have the Bloom effect show up on your camera, all you really need to do is use a standard material with the emissive texture and make sure that your camera can handle it. The relevant files that implement Bloom are in Bevy core pipeline source bloom, which is a mod.rs file and a WGSL file. The mod.rs file is about 800 lines of code, so it's not really going to fit in this video. But if you're familiar with the shaders and the pipelines that we've talked about in the past, and you can read render pipelines, you'll be able to tell exactly what's going on here, because it's basically just setting up a render pipeline for the bloom, extracting the necessary materials, preparing them, and queuing them up. The bloom settings that we set in our application come straight into the bloom WGSL file. So we get the threshold, the knee, the scale, and the intensity as F32s inside of this WGSL file. So that's bloom. Again, this is not a lighting effect, or it's not something that I would consider a lighting effect. It is an effect that a light source or something that looks like a light source can have on the display on the camera. So as these spheres go up and down, you can see some of them go behind other balls, but they aren't actually emitting light from their sphere onto the other gray spheres. We just get the feathering effect that comes off of the emissive color. So that's it. I'm just really excited about bloom. I want to go back through some of my shaders and implement bloom for some of the shields, because I think that bloom is a really, really sick effect, and it adds a lot to things that are supposed to look like they are emitting light. And I'm just super excited that Bevy keeps getting better and better every time I look at it. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I will catch you in the next one, and maybe go play with bloom in your Bevy apps. Of course, you'll have to use the main branch right now, because 0.9 has not been released yet, and this PR went in between the 0.8 and 0.9 releases. Have a great day, and I'll catch you in the next one.